Today's video is about why building a dream recall is so important, and how if you keep a good, accurate dream journal and you make that a habit of your morning routine, you're going to have a lot of lucid dreams. And I'll explain what I mean by that in a minute here. So when you're building a good dream recall, some people say, you know, I don't dream at all, and some people have very vivid dreams every night. Everybody dreams. It just depends on the amount that you remember. And then every morning when you wake up, even if you just remember one scene or one person you were with, maybe you don't even remember any of the dream, but you remember you were with one of your best friends, or you were with your dog or your cat, you just write down, I was with my cat, and that's it. And it will start to build up pretty significantly. And the reason this is so powerful is because it really starts to ingrain inside of your subconscious with you setting that intention of keeping the dream journal every morning. You're bringing more of your awareness towards the subject. And then at nighttime, when you reread those dreams before you go into bed, it's just a really good way that you're priming your body to have these experiences. And once you start to keep a dream journal and you start to see how good your recall has gotten, you'll go from just having a few words. And this is a personal thing. This is my own personal example. I've gone from just having a few words. When you start off, obviously, maybe you just remember a feeling. I was really scared. I don't even remember the dream. I just remember that I was somewhat frightened in the dream. So you just write down even a feeling you can remember. That will eventually lead to you writing down super, super detailed dreams. And like I was saying, my own personal thing is I went from just having a feeling to a little bit more remembered of the dream to, after doing this consecutively, I ended up waking up and being able to write like multiple days of a dream. Now, I realized when I was dreaming, I did not actually go through multiple days, but in my dream, I had a full day of this event. I went to bed in the dream, and then I woke up in that dream and I had another full day. And then when I woke up actually in my bed, I was writing down in as much detail all of this information. And it was basically an entire 2-day dream that I remembered 99% of the entire thing, or at least I'm pretty sure I do. Now, that to me blew me away, because I'm like, okay, I went from just having a feeling about a month ago in my first note in my dream journal to now basically 2 days of a full-blown, very vivid dream that I remember pretty much all of it. Now, that again is just going to help prime you to have these experiences in a lucid dream, and you're building up your dream recall, and that's going to help you have an experience. But more importantly, actually, when you start to build up that dream recall, you're actually going to notice that you've had lucid dreams that night that you completely forgot about. Now, when I first started to read about these in some of the books, I remember I read in one of Robert Monroe's books, and this is about out-of-body experiences, but they're very similar. He was talking about how he would try to do dream recall, and sometimes he would forget his experiences in local one. And I was thinking, okay, so how could he forget that if he had a conscious OBE? How could he then forget it and then come back but still write about it? And then I really understood, I might have kind of butchered that a little bit. I didn't want to go too much into Robert Monroe and his Journeys Out of the Body book. I don't want to kind of ruin that for anybody. But what I'm trying to get at is, you will forget sometimes that you've had a lucid dream until you do the dream recall. And that, again, like I said, that's odd until you experience it yourself, because you're thinking, okay, how can you forget that you had that experience? Because in order to have a lucid dream, you have to become conscious in the dream. You have to gain awareness in your environment. So how can you then forget that you even did that, right? You might not remember the entire lucid dream, but how can you even forget that you even had your 7 fingers, or you had the hand or the finger go through your hand? So once you start to build up that good dream recall, you will start to notice you're writing down your dreams. And again, this has happened to me personally. You write down your dreams, and as you're writing down, you go, you know, you have multiple dreams a night. You go to your other dream and you're like, okay, I was doing this, I was doing this. And then you're like, whoa, I had a full lucid dream last night. I remember in that moment, I counted my fingers. I had 7, and I did this, and then I did that, and then I did this. And so, but when I woke up from that sleep in my bed, I didn't remember I had a lucid dream at all. And most of my lucid dreams, when I wake up in the morning, I completely remember them immediately. I'm excited, I'm ecstatic. I want to tell whoever's around me that, you know, this experience was really fun, or, and you know, whatever version of your lucid dream that you do, it's exciting when you have one. And so you usually do remember them. But when I woke up and I started to do these dream journals, and every morning when I woke up, I did realize that I had missed quite a few lucid dream moments. And then I was like, okay, if I've been doing this for years, since I was even in grade school, and I was like, how many have I missed? And how many have I not been aware of because I haven't had this habit really ingrained in my daily habits? Again, when I just kind of took it nonchalantly and just, you know, halfway did it, I didn't really see those results. But when I made it a habit, I absolutely saw a far more increase of the amount of lucid dreams that I could remember. Now, I'm not saying this is increasing the amount of lucid dreams you're going to have, but when you have a lucid dream, you do have the option, you do have the chance, you might just straight up forget the entire experience. And keeping that dream journal and that good dream recall always at the forefront of your mind is going to allow you to remember those experiences. Remember, you don't want to forget any of these experiences you're going through. You're putting effort, intention, a lot of desire to have these, so you don't want to miss out on any of them. And as always, remember, this shit is so easy, you can do it in your sleep.